Have you ever dreamed of living on a movie set? Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 houses from movies and TV you could have actually owned. Before we begin, we publish new content every day, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. For this list, we're looking at on-screen houses that are either currently for sale or have been on the market in recent years. Number 10. Murder House, American Horror Story.
Welcome. It's a classic LA Victorian, built around 1920 by the doctor to the stars at the time. It's just fabulous.
The murder house from the first season of American Horror Story is actually the Rosenheim Mansion, located in Los Angeles, California. A famous home that's been on screen a few times, also notably in an episode of Buffy the Vampire Slayer. For American Horror Story, though, the sets used for the interior scenes were created as exact replicas of the actual rooms of the grand home. A couple bought the house in 2014 for $3.2 million and started a legal battle with their realtors after the fact because of the vast number of American Horror Story fans who trespassed on the property. Before the house was ultimately sold, it was actually listed on Airbnb, meaning fans could have spent the night there. Number 9. Bella's House, the Twilight franchise. The Twilight movies are set in Forks, Washington, but the house that Bella and her father lived in is actually located one state over. In August 2015, longtime owner Dean Koenig listed this St. Helens, Oregon home for just $349,900, meaning that a serious Twihard could get to live in their favorite fandom for a pretty darn reasonable price. Well, if you have that sort of money. Koenig said, quote, "When people come here, they actually can connect to that world, and that world becomes a little more real to them." It ended up selling above asking for $363,000.
Cleared some shelves off in the bathroom.
Oh, right. One bathroom.
Number 8. Balls Park, The Young Victoria. Much of the story told in The Young Victoria takes place in famed British monarchy mainstays like Kensington Palace and Buckingham Palace. The problem is, though, being granted access to film there doesn't happen often. So when the filmmakers needed a stand-in, they opted for Balls Park in Hartford. The Grade 1 listed Balls Park estate has been portioned into a variety of apartments and duplexes, meaning that you could own a piece of this historic manor. Prices are steep, though, with the first apartment being listed at £1.5 million. Who's in? Number 7. The Matthews Home, Boy Meets World. If you grew up religiously watching TGIF to kick off your weekend, you probably would have loved to snag this choice piece of real estate. In 2016, the house that was used for the exterior shots of the Matthews home on Boy Meets World went on for sale for $1.5 million. The show may have been set in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, but because of Hollywood production standards, the house is actually located in LA. It's a two-bedroom, two-bathroom home situated in the desirable Colfax Meadows neighborhood of Studio City, and living there would bring you right back to the 90s. Number 6. The McAllister House, Home Alone. Here's another piece of nostalgia. When you watched Home Alone as a kid, you probably related to Kevin and his struggles with the burglars. But as an adult, you may have paid a little more attention to the gorgeous piece of real estate that acts as the main scene for all the action.
This is my house. I have to defend it.
The McAllister family residence is located in a suburb of Chicago, and in 2012, sold for a cool $1.5 million. Though the exterior still looks much like it did in 1990, the inside of the house was actually replicated on a soundstage for much of the filming process.
This magnificent staircase greets you as you enter the home, but it's really not suitable for sledding or tobogganing.
Number 5. Sam's Houseboat, Sleepless in Seattle. The creators of romantic comedies are always game for new and interesting settings to place their characters in. And for the genre classic Sleepless in Seattle, the producers chose to have their male lead, the wonderful Tom Hanks, live in a houseboat. That's pretty cool. And if you think this is a humble abode, you would be incorrect, because the specs of the boat are 2,200 square feet and 4 bedrooms. It sold for $2 million in 2008. Using movie magic, the inside of Sam and Jonah's home was filmed on a set elsewhere. Number 4. The Tanner House, Full House. The most iconic homes to appear in every episode of Full House were undoubtedly the famed painted ladies that are shown at the end of the intro. While as a kid you may have thought that's where the Tanner family lived, the exterior of their actual family home is located at 1709 Broderick Street in San Francisco. Like many of the other examples on our list, the inside of the real home definitely does not match what you saw on TV. The house went on sale in 2016 and ended up selling for a whopping $4 million to the former executive producer of the show. Number 3. The Brady House, The Brady Bunch.
Here's the story of a lovely lady who was bringing up three very lovely girls.
In the summer of 2018, a truly iconic TV home went on sale for the first time in decades. The house used for the exterior shots of The Brady Bunch had been occupied by the same owner since a family purchased it in the early 1970s. 11222 Dilling Street in North Hollywood was listed for just under $2 million, but ended up selling for $3.5 million to HGTV after real estate agents fielded requests from hundreds of people who wanted to own a piece of television history. If only Alice came with it.
Well, Mrs. Brady, I don't know how you do it.
Do what?
Take a tiny seed, some dirt, and a little water and get a beautiful flower. Whenever I try it, all I get's a muddy seed.
Number 2. The Dursley's House, the Harry Potter franchise. Of all the wonderful places that Harry and his friends go in the Harry Potter movies, number 4 Privet Drive is probably the least magical of them all. The home of Harry's mean muggle family went up for sale, and no, it's not in Little Whinging, Surrey, because that's not a real place. It's actually located in Bracknell, Berkshire, on a street called Picket Post Close, which actually sounds pretty rolling-esque. Oh, and if you're wondering, there really is a cupboard under the stairs for the nephew you never really wanted.
Wake up, cousin! We're going to the zoo!
Before we unveil our number one pick, here are some honorable mentions.
Oh, that's great. She called you and you bust the birthday party. That's great!
Don't you dare make me out to be the monster here, Daniel! Don't you dare!
Let's go inside. There's no smoking in this house.
Number 1. Ennis House, Blade Runner. The great Frank Lloyd Wright was, unsurprisingly, ahead of his time when he designed his famed Ennis House in the 1920s, as his unique geometric design fit perfectly into Ridley Scott's sci-fi world a half century or so later in Blade Runner. Though the home is best known for its appearance in this film, it's actually appeared in a wide number of productions over the years. In the summer of 2018, the house went on sale for $23 million. The price tag may be incredibly steep, but the house itself is enormous at 6,000 square feet, and the interior is just as remarkable as the outside. Do you agree with our picks? Check out these other great clips from WatchMojo, and be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.